Let us discuss about average pressure on side walls of a vessel. Here you can see a vessel is there which is filled up to the top, up to say a height H with a liquid. The dimensions of the container are H, L and W if we consider the liquid is filled up to the top. In this situation, at every point in contact with the side wall, due to fluid pressure, the force will be acting in the direction along outward normal of the wall. Say we wish to find out the average pressure exerted by the liquid which is in contact with the side wall. Obviously, we know at bottom pressure is more as depth is more. So, liquid will push the wall in outward direction with more force. The liquid which is at the top, the depth is less. So, we can say it will push the wall in outward direction with lesser force. So, in this situation, if we wish to find out the total force acting on this wall, we consider from the free surface at a depth y, we consider an elemental strip on the side wall which is of width dy. Now, we can simply state the liquid particle which are just behind this strip will push this strip in outward direction with the force df. So, if we find out the pressure due to fluid, here we are talking about gauge pressure only, which is due to fluid only, at a point behind the elemental strip is, here we can simply state the pressure will be y rho g as we are not considering p atmospheric because we are finding out the pressure only due to the fluid. So, the pressure just behind the strip of width dy will be y rho g because this point is at a depth y below the free surface of the liquid. And if we find out the force, or more precisely we should write outward force on elemental strip, which is obviously due to the fluid pressure, is this can be written as df, and here df will be y rho g multiplied by the area of this strip, which can be written as w dy. And if we find out the total force on a side wall of vessel due to fluid pressure is, this can be calculated as total force as integration of this df, and will integrate this expression y rho g w dy within limits from 0 to h, because the total height up to which the liquid is filled is h, so we'll integrate this variable y from 0 to h. And here only y is the variable, rho g w is a constant, so the result will be rho g w. It will be y square by 2 within limits from 0 to h. So, you can see the result we are getting is half rho g w h square. This is the total force acting on the side wall which is in contact with the fluid in area h w. So, we can directly find out the average pressure on side wall is, average pressure can be directly written as the total force on side wall divided by the total area of the wall which is in contact with the fluid, that is height is h and its width is w, so it can be written as f by hw. If we substitute the value of f here, it will be half of rho gw h square by hw. Here w and h gets cancelled out, it is half h rho g. This is quite an important relation to be kept in mind. This you can simply write the half pressure which fluid exert on bottom. This is half of the pressure which fluid exert on bottom, as we know that at bottom pressure is h rho g, and if we find out the average pressure on the side wall, it is simply half of the pressure which liquid is exerting, the fluid is exerting at the bottom of the container. So just keep this point always in your mind, as in many applications directly we are going to use this result.